Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Connect. My name is Adrian, and I'm joined by Evan Wakefield, who's part of our SimpleLink Wireless Automotive Apps team. So thanks for coming by.
Yeah, no, it's a pleasure. I'm glad to be here.
Totally. And I know we've got a really cool demo, but before we jump into that, today we want to talk a little bit about angle of arrival.
Yeah.
And maybe for the uninitiated, could you maybe walk through what that is?
Absolutely. So in Bluetooth, there's different types of specifications. And recently, Bluetooth announced BLE 5.1, or Bluetooth 5.1. And the new thing with Bluetooth 5.1 is that you can actually have angle of arrival and angle of departure as a part of the specification. And so what we have here today is we're showing that angle of arrival capability and where it can be used.
Okay, and where can that be used? I mean, so angle of arrival, the name seems to describe itself, but maybe you can dive into a little bit more detail.
Absolutely. It is pretty self-descriptive, but you would mainly see it probably in car access or in asset tracking of some sort. And so that's kind of the areas that we're targeting with our current solution today is car access, specifically in passive entry, passive start systems. And then eventually we'll get into asset tracking as well.
Okay, very cool. And typically when I think about localization, I know RSSI has typically been used in the past. Mm-hmm. Is this augmenting that? Is this adding additional capability on mm-hmm. top of that?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. And it's definitely adding to it, I would say. BLE has been used in a lot of different ways doing localization with RSSI. And the limitation to it is that there's actually a limit of the amount of resolution that you can get. What angle of arrival is doing is it's actually giving you a better way to triangulate the position of a device. And it gives you that extra data to actually give you a little bit more resolution in your localization algorithm.
OK, very cool. And what does that mean as an end user, an end customer? If I'm approaching a vehicle, what does that enable?
You can enable a variety of things. So the first thing is car access. And so a lot of people are working on passive entry, passive start systems. We have products that are actually in production with passive entry, passive start systems. Cool. And the next phase of that is angle of arrival. A few other things that might be kind of fun to see and play with as people learn the technology and learn how to customize it is maybe actually doing some sort of like adding personality to your car, whether or not you come by the trunk and the BLE device will actually detect that you're next to the trunk, it'll open the trunk or turn on some lights, really personalize your experience with your car. It can be used in a variety of different areas as well, probably like e-locks and asset tracking and open up some new capabilities in the market.
Okay, so not just in the automotive space, but potentially building automation could benefit from this use case
as
well.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think one of the things that's really important to note with angle of arrival is its interoperability. Everybody knows Bluetooth. Bluetooth isn't everything. As long as that device supports BLE 5.1, you can do angle of arrival. So it's something that's pretty exciting that we're really looking forward to, seeing how it grows in the market and how people adopt it into new technologies.
Love it. So this means I don't have to bring my own key fob anymore. I can use things like my phone as a key.
Yeah, potentially. It opens up a wide range of things. You could even use your key fob if you wanted still too, but it opens up a wide range of possibilities.
Love it. Love it. And I guess to demonstrate that and maybe give the audience a little bit more tangible experience with angle of arrival, we have a demo here.
Absolutely. So one of the things that we're just going to kind of talk about at a high level first is the concept of angle of arrival. In angle of arrival, what's new is there is a constant tone that's actually appended to the end of a BLE packet. And that tone gets transmitted over the air. And you'll actually have something, two antennas that will be measuring the phase difference of that tone as it propagates across that antenna. And from that IQ data, you can actually use some trigonometry and eventually calculate your angle. And what we're showing here today is actually a TI design that TI has made called the TIDA-01632. And here what we have is there's actually two antennas on this board, dipole antennas in this instance. And we actually have a transmitter that's going to be transmitting that constant tone. So as I move this across, you'll actually see some response on the GUI right here.
Okay, so this launchpad kit here, that's a stand-in for the key fob or your Bluetooth.
Exactly. You can imagine this as a phone, as a key fob. Really anything that has Bluetooth inside of it.
Okay, very cool. Awesome. Yeah, let's take a look at the demo.
Yeah, let's do it real quick. So I'll just connect the device right here, and it starts streaming some data to the GUI. And as I take this device right here and move it across the plane of the antennas, you'll actually see the GUI respond accordingly.
That's awesome.
And so this is just some of the basic functionality that you can provide inside of a localization algorithm of some sort that would go into your application that you're designing today.
Really cool demo, Evan. Thank you so much for that. And I guess, what are some of the system-level benefits of angle of arrival?
Yeah, absolutely. So let's talk about car access just to get it a little bit focused, and we can branch out from there. In car access, people need a lot of nodes to be able to get the kind of resolution with RSSI today in their localization algorithms. What this will actually do is it'll actually give you more data and allow you to actually reduce that number of nodes, so it can be a system cost saver over time as well, as you learn how to design your systems with angle of arrival.
So we're actually optimizing the system, but still at the same time getting more information out of it.
Exactly, exactly.
Win-win situation, yeah. Very cool. Yeah. And I guess what's next for TI in this space?
Yeah. So TI has actually been involved with the Bluetooth SIG from the beginning on angle of arrival. We actually helped write the specification with the Bluetooth SIG, and we're involved with a lot of different conversations to increase the next frontier for Bluetooth Low Energy.
Very cool. And I guess what's next for TI in this space?
Yeah, so TI has been involved from the very beginning with the Bluetooth SIG and defining the specification for AOA. And we're continuing to work with the Bluetooth SIG on the next frontier of technology with the Bluetooth SIG. So.
Oh, cool. Yeah, so we'll stay tuned. We'll bring you back on the show to talk a little bit about some of the future capabilities.
Exactly. Yeah, I would really enjoy that. It would be a lot of fun.
Fantastic. Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Evan. And you mentioned a TI design. Where can customers learn more about this capability?
Yeah, so there's a couple different places that you can actually go to kind of learn about angle of arrival. We have our 5.1 stack available. You can download it off the web. It's the CC13X2 26X2 SimpleLink SDK. Okay. And also, you can go buy a booster pack that's out there today called the AOA booster pack. We'll provide a link on a little bit below. And then I would also say SimpleLink Academy is a great place to go. If you're new engineer, or even if you're an experienced engineer, you can go to SimpleLink Academy, and there's a variety of trainings that actually talk about Bluetooth, all of our other wireless technologies, but also specifically RTLS and AOA. It would be a great place to go.
Cool. Lots of content.
Yeah, a lot of content.
Very cool. Well, Evan, thank you so much for hanging out. And thank you guys for watching. Be sure to tune in next week, where we'll bring in another expert to talk more about the SimpleLink platform. And also, if you have any feedback, feel free to tweet at us at Sensor2Cloud. Feel free to share any new topic ideas or any feedback in general. We'd love to hear from you. Well, thank you so much, and we'll catch you next week.